I'm Louise from SuperHigh, and in this video, I'm going to explain how to scale fonts for different screen sizes. Today, websites are viewed from a variety of different screens and resolutions, so your designs need to scale accordingly. This also applies to your type. On smaller screens, there's less space, so using a smaller font size makes sense. On larger screens, there's more room for designs like multi-column layouts, and these screens also tend to be viewed at a greater reading distance, which makes larger font sizes more suitable. To avoid designing different layouts for every possible screen size, many websites are created using responsive web design. This is the idea that your layout automatically adapts to the device's viewport. So, how do we go about scaling type in code? Let's take a look at some units we can use to set font size. First up, we've got pixels. Pixels are one of the most commonly used measurements on the web. They're both a simple and precise way of setting your font size. However, using pixels for font size has a few big drawbacks. Namely, that pixels are static units and do not scale on their own. Setting your font size with pixels also means that your users are unable to manually adjust their font size to suit their eyesight through their browser settings, which can lead to bad user experience. So, what are our other options? Well, next up, we've got M and Rem. M and Rem are flexible units of measurement that adjust your font size or layouts according to the size of a base font, but they work slightly differently. M inherits the font size from its parent element. So, if the parent element's font size is set to 18 pixels, then 1M is equal to 1 times 18, which translates to 18 pixels. If font size is not defined by an immediate parent element, font size will be set by the root element, HTML. If font size has not been set on the root element, the font size will be set by the browser settings, which in most browsers defaults to 16 pixels. M's work great the majority of the time, but inheritance can throw in a few issues. Font size set using M's will compound. Let's take a look at an example. Here we have a parent element whose font size is inherited from the browser's default settings at 16 pixels. Inside we have two nested child elements. The font size is set on these child elements in our CSS to 2m. We can see that the font sizes of the child elements are different here. One ends up being 16 times 2 at 32 pixels, and the other compounds and ends up at 16 times 2 times 2, which is 64 pixels. So, the effect of M units can be compounding when multiple M font-sized elements are used within one another. This can become a problem and lead to unintended consequences in your designs. This problem is actually the reason why the Rem unit was invented. Rem units are not affected by the size or setting of a parent element, and are instead based only on the HTML element. This makes Rem units easier to manage. If the font size of the HTML element is set to 16 pixels, then 1 rem will equal 16 pixels. Rems can be safer to use as a font size unit for this reason. There are some other units of measurement that are responsive to the size of the screen your site is being viewed from. These are called viewport units. And there are VW, VH, Vmin and VMax. These units are explicitly tied to the viewport's dimensions. So, for example, 1VW would be equal to 1% of the viewport width, 1VH would be equal to 1% of the viewport height, and we then have 1Vmin and VMax, which is equal to 1VW or VH, whichever is smaller, or larger for 1Vmax. So, if your font size is set to 5VW and the viewport of your device is 400 pixels wide, the font size will come out at 20 pixels. Let's take a look at these in action. Here we've got some basic HTML set up with a H1 containing our largest heading and some paragraph text and a H2 with another heading. In our CSS, I've set the following. The H1 is set to be 5% of the viewport width. The H2 is 4% of the viewport width, or 4VW. And finally, the paragraph text is set to be 3% of the minimum width or height of the viewport, whichever is smaller. This works great at certain screen sizes, but when we shrink the screen down to represent mobile screens, or increase it to represent desktop screens, the text starts to look too small or too large. A way to fix this is to use media queries to set minimum and maximum font sizes. Media queries allow us to apply styles when certain thresholds are met. The first, which we've got here, sets the largest size our font can be for screens over 1,000 pixels wide. The second sets the smallest size our font can be for screens under 400 pixels wide. To set the font sizes here, I'm going to use Rem. So each font size will be tied to the browser default of 16 pixels. When we use Rems, a good tip is to think of the pixel value we want and then work backwards, dividing that by the root font size. So if our H1 should be at its largest 48 pixels, we divide 48 by 16 to get 3 Rem. Now if I increase or decrease the size of our viewport, we can see the media queries kick in and the Rem values being set. There are a number of different ways you can scale type on the web, but in reality, the most important thing to remember is to always test your designs on different devices to make sure you're delivering the user experience you want.